What is custom formatter? Formatter function is used to convert more technical representation of data into human readable text. Whatever data which is complex, and if we want to format it, we can use the formatter function. To create a formatter function, we need to follow the following steps. The first step is to create a formatter.js file in the model folder, and then define the formatter in associated controller.js file. In the library define section, we need to define the path for the formatter file. Just about the onInit function, we need to mention formatter colon formatter with a comma separated value. Then we have to define the formatter function in XML. Wherever the property, the model property, which is complex in details, and we want to format this value, so we have to put a comma and then provide the formatter path, formatter dot formatter dot the method that we are going to apply in the formatter.js file. Then we have to write the custom logic function in the formatter. So the function name is get percentage. For example, we need to write the get percentage function in the formatter.js file. In this video, we are going to learn about formatter, and we will see these steps in the practical way. So please watch the video till end, and I promise that you would never forget how to use the custom formatters. We have already discussed the expression binding, which is a sort of alternative for the formatter functions, but the custom formatter functions are still important and relevant. So let's understand it in the practical way. Hello everyone. Today we will learn about the custom formatters. Formatters are extremely useful when we need to format the value coming from the data services. And we can format the value and we can display as the way we want. So let's start. In our application, bank details application, this was our bank details.json file where we were adding the values as percentage. These were the percentage values. And I also added one more property called employee salary. Now we will check the spending EMIs and entertainment amount against this employee salary, and we'll get the percentage value. So now I will remove the percentage value and I will put the actual values like 40,000. And for 21.5, I can put 21,500. And entertainment, I can put 38,500. So this is the employee salary, 1 lakh. And the employee is spending 38,500 on entertainment, 21,500 on EMI, and household spending is 40,000. Now we need to calculate these values and we'll display it on our donut chart. So this is the one change that we have done. And to create the formatter function, we have to create a formatter file. So first I will go to my view and let's see what we written earlier. This was our interactive donut chart where we have the values and we are reading the values directly. If I run the application at this stage, so probably application won't run, and the reason being because this value and display value only accept the data which are in calculation with the percentage. So but still we run the application. My bank underscore details. Okay, sorry, cd my bank underscore details. Okay, and to run the application, we need to write npm start run. Meanwhile, we'll make our changes. And I'll create a formatter file and a formatter function. Probably the application won't run without error. Now, if I see the documentation for custom formatter, they have defined that we have to create a formatter.js file. So we'll copy paste the code from here so I don't have to write, but I will explain you each and everything. So now I will go to my model folder. Inside model folder, I'll create my formatter file. I'll create a new file and I'll give it a name, formatter.js. Now my new file is created. And inside this new file, I'll copy paste the same code, what they have maintained. I copy this code, go to my formatter file and paste it there. This is a status text. This is a function. So I'll remove the existing function because we will write on our own custom logic here. This is the same as SAP UI define, where we can define any SAP UI library if in case we are using any custom control or anything. So for now in this written object, this is what the formatter file would written. So here we can write our custom logic, everything what we want to write. So we'll write our custom logic. And right now, let's see if application is working fine or not. If it will work, it will display the values as 40,000, 38,000, 35,000, 28,000. Okay, so at least the values are coming, but this is not the actual percentage, so the value is not correct, which is displayed. So we have to format this value. And to do that, I will write a custom logic here in my formatter function. And for a time being, if we have done the UI define everything, we have to go through the documentation, because to use the formatter, we have to, before writing the custom logic, we have to put all the places, like in controller file, wherever we want to use the associated controller to that view, we have to define the path of the formatter function, formatter file, and we have to define formatter colon formatter here. So I'll go to my app.controller file, and inside this file, I will put the path of the formatter file, which is model slash formatter, because I have created the file inside the model folder, formatter.js inside the model folder. And this double dot would, right now we are in the controller. So from controller to, we will go to the application namespace, the actual path web app folder. And from web app folder, if we read from controller, if you want to jump through it, so you'll put double dot and slash, you'll come to the web app. From web app, you want to move to the model. So I have put slash model. And then from model, we want to move to the formatter. So this is the way to define the formatter file here. The another thing we have to mention is we have to mention the formatter namespace inside this function. So after controller, you can put formatter. And now just above the onInit function, as per the standard documentation, the formatter we have to copy, and using a comma separated value, just about the onInit function. So this is the formatter declaration is done. Now we can absolutely use the formatter and we can put the function in the view. So I have saved it and I'll close my controller file. Now I also put the some custom logic in the controller file. So I will actually copy the logic that, so we don't have to write it again and again. Now I'll go to my formatter file and I'll paste this logic. Now let me explain you what this logic is about. There is a function called get percentage. We'll get the value from the formatter declaration in the XML. And here I'm reading the employee salary property that we have defined in our bank details, the employee salary. And since the double values are not getting passed, there's a bug in UIFI that later I'll share with you. Else we could have passed both the values using this parameter we could have read, but right now we cannot do that. So we are reading it from the get owner component.get model function using get property. So once I get this property, I'm converting the value in percentage value. I'm dividing the value by employee salary and multiplying it by 100. So it is returning me the percentage value. As you remember here, instead of 40,000, it should display 40%. So I'm getting the value here 40, right? So this is the way. So we will also run the application. I'll put a debugger here so you can read it. Debugger. So once the application would run, we can stop the execution. I can probably show you what's there inside this code block. Okay, so for now, the formatter debugger won't work because we haven't defined, we haven't called this function. We have to call it using the formatter method. So I'll go to my bank details fragment, and probably we can read how to call the formatter method. So they have called it using a comma separated value, formatter dot the function name. So we will do the same because we have done the path and the binding we have done. So if I can quickly go to my values. So first we'll apply for the house spending. I'll put a path colon bank details, and probably we have to put it in the comma separated. Okay. So we will put the apostrophe here for the binding, then comma, then formatter.status text. Now let's read what is the function name is the get percentage. So I will put get percentage here. So this is the way to call the formatter function, because using the path and formatter, then colon, and then formatter.getPercentage is the actual function name that we have put in a formatter file. And now let's read. And now the formatter function would get triggered. So let's put the debugger here. Okay, right now our application not running. And the reason being, there are double comma we have put in our XML. So I'll remove one comma. And now the application would work fine, and the debugger would trigger the function that we have defined inside the formatter.js file. So I can display what the values we are getting in this one, how it is converting it into the percentage value. So let me run the application again. Debugger is on its place, so probably it would trigger now. Our debugger function, debugger has stopped the code execution. Now let me make it little bit okay. I think you can see it now clearly in the sources. Debugger has hit. Now what is there in component.getModel.getProperty? So we are reading the employee salary property is coming 1 lakh. Now we are converting the O value is is what the binding value right now, the 40,000 that we are getting for spending, because we have put the formatter function there, and now we are converting. So we are dividing the value from the employee salary and multiplying by 100. If I can put one more line of execution, I can see the percentage value is coming as 40. So this is the value that we want to display. So I'll put next. Now let's see what we are getting. I'm sorry, this like keeping it up and down is extremely difficult. So the reason right now it is displaying as 40,000, it is because we have put our formatter on the value, but the display value is different. So the same code will copy paste for display value as well. And what will happen eventually, we'll get the percentage value here, because this is the value that we are calculating, but this is the value that we are displaying. So both the places we have to put the formatter. If I don't put it here, it might not work because it won't accept the different value. So let's put it on both the places. But if you don't put it on the value property, it might work as it is. So this is the way to display, to change the formatting. And right now the same code block is executed and we are getting the 40 as a value. And here the percentage value that it will return is the 40%. And if you can see, now we are getting the 40%. This percentage mark is coming by this, right? This is not the part of the function that we are calling in the formatter. Formatter is only providing us the value of the percentage. But as we know that because of this logic, this value is authenticated. Now we will do the same logic. We will put the same logic for other entries as well. So there are other entries like, okay, let's do one thing. Remove the formatter for value. If it works fine, we won't write the formatter here. Let's check if it is working fine. We are getting the 40%. It means it is working fine. So we don't have to put the formatter for the value. We will put the formatter only for displayed values. Now for another one, there is the for EMI, we'll put the same logic. And so what I will do, I will copy the same thing and I will paste it here. And the percent mark should be there because now we'll get the percentage value. And instead of house spending, I'll put here EMI. And the same way, I will copy paste the same code for this display value. And because I need the entertainment, I will remove the entertainment, remove the mark and binding property. I'm so sorry. There's an email. Okay, this is a blunder I did. Okay, this is the entertainment. For bank details, entertainment. Now, ideally, we should get the properties for all of these displayed value for all of these segments of the interactive donut chart. And if I can remove the breakpoint. Okay, so we are getting the percentage value. If you see, 21.5%, 38.5%. And what is the value in our JSON format? We are putting the value 40,000, 21,000. So it means our formatter logic is working fine. Right, so one logic is done. We have built one logic successfully. We'll remove the debugger from here. Now let's do formatting for these colors. Right now it is error, critical, and good. So let's build a logic for these colors as well and put them in place. So this should be visible based on the value received, not the hard coding values. So what I do, I have built a logic for this as well. And I remove this code. I'll explain you what this code does. With a comma separated value as controller, we can put another function. And by using the control slash, we can remove the comment. And now, first we are reading the employee salary, then we are converting into the percentage, and then we are putting a condition. If the percentage value is greater than 60, then return error. If it is greater than 40, then return critical. If it is else, it is in the good, so return the good value. So error, critical, and good, these are string value that we are returning for color, because color accept the critical, error, and good. These are the string values. So what I will do, I will put the formatter, and on basis of what we are doing it, on the basis of the values that we are receiving, the value. And what is this O value? This O value is the value that we are getting from the JSON model, right? So now what I will do, I will copy paste the same code without this percentage mark here, and I will replace, because I want to pass the house spending value to my function, and my another function name is get state. So I copy this and I replace the get percentage function with the get state. copy the get state and I replace the value of get percentage with get state, right? The same thing I have to do for other colors as well, like for critical. And the same method would work for all three of them. And for formatter, get state, get state, get state. So this is the way to do it. Now let's see if our application is running. So I can display what we are getting in the property. So if I put a breakpoint here, I can display you what is the values that we are getting. So right now we are getting good for all three. So if I can replace, and one more thing we have to do is that right now the colors we are getting all green because we are using only house spending property of our JSON model. So, but if we want the color for loan EMI, we have to put that, we have to pass the EMI value. So instead of house spending, I'll pass EMI. If we want to put the color for entertainment, we have to pass the entertainment property instead of house spending. Now our calculation would be done. So right now this is our function and it is getting triggered. So I remove the breakpoint for from get percentage and I focus on this. And this is a percentage value, I'm getting 40. Now it will, the if condition, it will check if 40 is greater than 60. So this is false, right? It is, so it won't execute, it won't return the error. It will see the next else if statement. If the percentage value is greater than 40, so percentage value is 40, so that's why it's not greater than 40. So it will not read this and it will pass the good. Now it will check for the other value. 40 is done. Now it will check for the 38. Okay, right now it is still building up the same logic. The reason being, we made the changes just now. I mean, these values. So it is reading only spending, house spending property, because earlier we put the house spending for all, but here we have to put EMI and entertainment. Now it will read all three properties. Now the breakpoint got to the, and let's see. Okay, now we are getting the first property, 21,500, and it is converting the percentage 21. 21 is not greater than 60, is not greater than 40, so it will display good. Now 38,000 is not greater than 60, is not greater than 40, so it will display good. But 40,000, it is not. So that's why all three are in the, all three are coming as green, right? But what if I change the value in my JSON and I say that this is not 40, this should be 65,000, or if on entertainment I'm spending now, assume 41,000 I'm spending on the entertainment and the EMI is 21,000 as it is. Now if we will see the changes of our app, now it will display the semantic colors to us. So you can notice here the household spending is 65%, which is critical, and the entertainment spending is 41.5, which is moderate, and loan EMI is 21.5. Now, apart from this, there is one more thing that we can do, is because these are the interactive color, and if you can notice, when I click on this, it is displaying these household spending critical and entertainment critical and loan EMI critical. It is displaying the value critical for all, so because it is critical. So let me see the loan EMI is critical. So there is a function that we can use and in our donor chart. And the function that we have used earlier was in the controller. And using the XML, we can find out what was the function name. And the function was on selection change. So I copy this, I go to my app control and I test. Okay, so we have put the get value. If it is greater than 50, then it will display critical, else it should display moderate. But right now what we can notice is that it is displaying critical for all, that it should not do. So we will check this function. And how do we check this? We'll put a debugger here. Please don't put the debugger in the production app. Once you complete the testing, please remove the debugger, because if debugger is there in the production app, then it will create a big issue. So always remember to remove the debugger. Put debugger for your reference to stop the code execution on that, please. And then these debuggers are fine that we define on the browser. These are fine because these are individual. So now if I click on this, now the code execution stopped on the on selection changed function is getting called. In the last video, we understood. And we are reading the property of the segment. Then we are reading the label. And then we are reading the get value. So what is the value I'm receiving? So that's the reason because the value is coming as 21,500, which is obviously greater than 50 because we have changed the value. So we have to put the same logic here on selection changed as well. The same logic that we are putting on the formator, we are converting the value in the percentage. So we have to convert the same value in the percentage. So I will go to my controller and I will change the logic. Before displaying it, I will put percentage value and the employee salary I need to get because we are getting it from the component level. So I will copy this code as well because we have to do this. And now this is the employee salary I'm getting. And then I'm getting the percentage value. So O value is divided by, so this O value should be the O segment dot get value, right? So first I have to read O segment. Are we using the segment? Okay, label we are using. So segment dot get value. So I can put let O value is equal to, and so the same O value could be used. O value is equal to O segment dot get value. Once we get the O value, once we get the employee salary, we will multiply it by 100. Then I will display the percentage value here instead of all segment dot get value. And if, sorry, it's a big problem. Okay. Now I'll place the percentage value instead of all segment dot get value, right? So now percentage value would be checked against the 50 and it will display the critical and moderate thing, right? So let me show you in the debugger, once the debugger would trigger. Okay, now debugger is in place. So we will click on the loan EMI. Now we will read segment value. We are getting 21,500. And then we are reading employee salary. We are getting 1 lakh. Then the percentage value is coming as 21.5. Now, whatever it will display the moderate because the 21, the percentage value, which is 21, is not greater than 50. So it will display as the moderate. Earlier, it was displaying critical for all. Now it is displaying moderate. Now, if I click on the household, it is critical because it is above the 50, and for this it is displaying moderate. So our logic is completed, and this is what the formatter is. So we have done the formatter. So I'll remove the debugger. We have understood what is formatter, formatter function that we have written here. Then we have made some changes in our controller logic as well, and so this is the way to write the logic in formatter. If you don't want to put these two lines again and again, you can put them in a separate function. And you can call that function as get percentage or get, you can put in a separate function and that's how you can read it. But if you keep it like that, then it's fine, it's not a problem. Okay, guys, let's meet in the next video. We will understand the responsiveness of our application. If I can quickly show you in the mobile application, this is how our application is looking right now. If I can put it in iPhone SE. So, which is not correct. I mean, in mobile, a user cannot see our application, right? Because it looks very, very ugly and the person can't read anything. So we will fix this problem. This is a problem. Our confidential detail fragment is loading just fine because we are already following the standard SAP guidelines. That's why it is coming fine. This is a standard control that we are loading. So in the same way, we should display these other values as well, right? So this is what we are going to fix in the next video. So please watch my next video. Let's meet. Thank you. And if you want to do an in-person SAP UFI training, Fury training, if you want to learn how to build the SAP UFI application using OData services or how to build that SAP UFI application, one that we are building, and if you want to build the more critical applications like timesheet applications and custom control, if you want to learn how to build it, so please join my live classes. I give live class on the Teach More platform, and there is a separate website. Tech2cindia.com. I will share the details about the website shortly. Thank you.